at the end of the day, it's a tough thing, but just trying to stay ready regardless of your minutes, regardless of.
Carsen, against the Washington Wizards, you dropped a career high 18 points, and you were on fire from three-point range, 4-for-5 from beyond the arc. What allowed you to get into such a rhythm?
I probably just said I had good looks, and my teammates got me the ball in good spots and be able to get good looks, and they were just able to go in. So,
you were able to do all that, though, coming off the bench for your team. And when you are coming off the bench, minutes, they can fluctuate, they can change. It can be hard to find that rhythm, though. How do you stay ready, prepping both physically and mentally?
Honestly, just being on the bench, just kind of watching the game. You get a flow for the game. You see the pace of it. You kind of see, you see things from a different angle than when you're on the floor. You may not see open spots and things like that. So best thing for me is just to sit there and try to pay attention and just kind of see the game, see the flow of it. So when I get in, at least I kind of know what spots. So at the end of the day, it's a tough thing, but just trying to stay ready regardless of your minutes, regardless. So
the other day on Twitter, Isaiah Thomas complimented you, saying that you got game and small guys can do it all. You also have had Dwayne Wade compliment you as well on your three-point shooting. Carsen, what does it mean to you to know that these guys are taking notice of your game?
I think that's pretty cool, man. Those are two guys that I mean have changed the game, in my opinion, and for me. So being able to know that they recognize me and stuff is pretty cool, man. And just it's humbling at the same time. It wants me to continue to work and continue to just try to improve and just continue to try to help my team win. So that's my main focus out of everything, is really just try to help my team win. So
we know this team is very close on and off the court. We have Michael Wharton, who wants to know something that you've learned so far from Kemba Walker that's really stood out to you.
I'd probably say, for me personally, what I learned from Kemba is just kind of understanding how the league and the seasons are, this up and down season, man. I learned from him, just seeing him, how, from not even telling me this personally, but just seeing him continue to play, continue even if missing shots, depending on how the game's going, continue to just play and stay the course and continue to play and not get too high, not get too low. And then after that, he still tells me the same thing, just knowing it's a long season, so just being ready. So I think that's the main thing I learned from him.